All right, what's going on, wedding family? It's Gene, the wedding coach, and I'm back, baby. I'm back. So I'm not going to be on here long. Just wanted to hop on here real quick and let you guys know that I just rocked a wedding this past weekend in Luray, Virginia for Stephanie and Drake, and we had a blast. And they only had 50 people there. 50 people. And everybody had a damn good time. So just want to encourage all of my couples out there. Couples that are planning their wedding for later on this year. Couples that are planning their wedding for 2022, 2023. And you may be having some challenges because of post-COVID or, some people can't attend your wedding. So you're like, you know, are people going to have a good time? Absolutely, yes. Right? I just rocked a wedding with 50 people. Now, I'll be honest with you, never done a wedding with 50 people before. All my weddings have typically been, 100, 150 people plus, right? But 150 people, we had a good time. Couple left there happy, guests left there happy, everybody had a blast. Now, why? Obviously, right, you have to come up with a strategy. And so when me and the couple were meeting, we already knew it was going to be 50 people. It was going to be a small, intimate wedding. And by the way, there's nothing wrong with that. You don't have to have 100, 150 people, 200 people at your wedding to have a good time. You could have 50 people. 50 are the most important people in your life. So I wrote a couple of tips here on why I think the couple had a great wedding last night. Okay. First and foremost, you and your guests make the wedding. Doesn't matter how many people are there. It could be 30 people, it could be 10 people, it could be 100 people. But you, the couple that's getting married, and the guest make up the wedding. And by the way, my bride was pregnant. And she was on the floor damn near the whole time with a little bump on her stomach. Okay? So you, the couple, you guys set the energy. You guys set the energy. Your guests are there for you. They ain't there for the venue. They're not there for the music. They're not there for the food or the alcohol. That's all extra. They're coming there to support you, to spend time with you, to celebrate with you, and to create memories for you. And so if you, the couple, if you guys are having a good time, everybody else is going to be having a good time. And a couple, like I said, the bride was on the dance floor all night. We did a couple of activities. I'm a big believer in getting your guests engaged and involved in your wedding. I think that's super important. There's so many things that we can do to creatively to get them engaged, right? But we did fun introductions. Introductions was amazing. Everybody came into a different song. Everybody had a different move that they did when they came in, right? So the beginning of the wedding, a lot of energy, okay? And you guys can do that, right? Find creative ways to do your intros, okay? We played the shoe game, right? Shoe game is a great way to get your guests engaged and involved in your wedding. The shoe game is also a great way for your guests to get to know you on a deeper level, all right? So, incorporating the shoe game, I think, is a great way to get your guests engaged in your celebration. We also did an anniversary dance, okay? Anniversary dance, once again, another great activity you can do during your wedding, not just to highlight the people that have been married the longest, but it's also a great way, once again, to get the married couple specifically engaged in your wedding. Now, obviously, you need to have good music, okay? And so having a good entertainer there that, knows the style of music that you want and knows the style of music that your guests want, okay, it's important. So yesterday, what did I play? I played country music. I played some 90s hip hop. I played some indie rock. What else? I played some 80s music, right? When you're doing weddings, I played some line dances, right? The Cupid Shuffle, Cotton Eye Joe, a couple of more, right? These are group dances. But when it comes to the music of your wedding, I look at it like the soundtrack of your wedding. Now, you got to understand, from an entertainer's point of view, as I'm playing music, or I know that there's only going to be 50 people there, it's my job to try to keep them engaged on the dance floor while I do that, and being able to touch all different genres of music while I do it. It takes skill to do that, right? And the guest gives me, I mean, the couple give me a playlist. I let guests come up to make requests, but I also have to like gauge the energy of the room, right? So if I'm playing high energy music and then switch it up to country music, right? Like, how do you do that transition? High energy music, right? You throw in a Cotton Eye Joe, it's a line dance, boom, and then you could switch up the genre of music that you're playing, right? So investing in a skilled entertainer, okay, regardless if you have 50 people or 150 people is important, right? Now, when you're investing in an entertainer, you want to make sure that the entertainer is qualified, right? He understands your style of music. He understands the genre of music that you want, all right? Obviously, good food, good alcohol, right, always makes for a good event. The couple also had a cigar bar. Once again, I've seen a lot of guys, partaking in a cigar bar. Once again, just because your guests are not fist pumping all night doesn't mean they're not having a good time. Just because your guests are not on the dance floor doesn't mean they're not having a good time. 50 people that were there, I'm telling you, everybody had a blast. There was a time in the wedding, everybody stepped outside. Now, that typically happens at Faithbrook in Luray, Virginia. It's overlooking the Shenandoah Valley. So what do you think the guests are going to do? You think they're going to stay inside the venue and not go outside and partake in this amazing experience? And they had a fire pit out there also, right? So you have beautiful scenery. Okay, you got good food. You got alcohol flowing. You got a cigar bar, right? You got a fire pit going. So you got s'mores going on. You got good music in the background. Come on. And you're celebrating with people that you love the most. Okay, all of these things that we did yesterday added to the fact that the couple had a blast and had a good time. Okay, and for the grand exit, what did they do? They did bubbles and glow sticks, right? Once again, another activity to get your guests engaged and involved in your wedding. So with that being said, guys, if just because you have 50 people at your wedding doesn't mean you guys are not going to have a good time. I know one of the biggest concerns that couples have at their wedding are people going to dance. Okay, are people going to have a good time? And they are, but it depends on you. You, the bride, the groom, you guys set the tone. Everything else is just added value, right? Your guests are coming there to celebrate with you, bottom line, right? You could be getting married at a VFW building. It wouldn't matter. The venue doesn't matter. Though it helps with the experience, but at the end of the day, it doesn't matter. What matters is the fact that they came, they RSVP'd, and they showed up, and they want to celebrate with you. That's the most important thing. And that's what creates a good wedding. I spent a lot of time trying to get to know my couples, okay? Because as an entertainer, if I don't know you, I can't represent you, okay? And so, you know, also making sure that your entertainer, I don't want to say knows you in an intimate way, but understands your vision and what it is that you're looking to do. Right? I always ask my couples, what's the most important thing? I've never had a couple say, hey, Gene, we want to have a boring wedding. Well, I'm not your guy, right? But the couple explained to me, Gene, we got 50 people. We don't know if our guests are going to dance. They're kind of on the conservative side. I said, all right, you know what? Then we need to, you know, create activities that will make them feel like they're part of your wedding. And with everything that I mentioned, right, it was a success. We had a great time. With that being said, guys, I highly recommend, if you guys are not following Gene the Wedding Coach, I'm doing daily wedding tips, tricks, and trends. Make sure you subscribe to the Wedding Workshop Podcast. All you got to do is click in the link in the profile. You can listen, you can subscribe. I got some of the hottest wedding vendors in the market, you know, giving you inside information. And I also got an ebook out right now, Wedding Planning 101. Get your free copy. Just click on the link. I'm working on 102 right now. Super excited. That should be here. That should be ready, I would say, by the fourth quarter this year. All right? So with that being said, guys, please feel free to comment on the video. Share the video. Let me know if you agree. Let me know how many people you're going to have at your wedding. Let me know what strategy you're going to have to get your guests engaged and involved in your wedding. And most importantly, guys, just remember why you're getting married during the planning phase of your wedding. All right? Gene, the Wedding Coach. Love you guys. I'm out. Deuces.